There's no better feeling than taking ordinary items and reorganizing them into something completely different. So for this video, we're taking Lego Technics sets and converting them into powerful, high-speed racing drones. Now you might be wondering where Nate is today. He is off prototyping, so for this video it's just going to be you and me. And I do have a confession to share. When I was young and growing up, I never got a chance to play with Lego. Honestly, the very first time I ever played with Lego was to make the Lego gummy video that is now currently the number one video on our channel. But that has all changed this year. We've teamed up with Lego. They reached out to us and said, what kind of cool things could you do with Lego? So this gave us a fantastic opportunity to put our minds into gear and play with some Lego. And I have been playing with a lot of Lego. Let me show you what I mean. Lego started sending us all these kits, and my very first experience with Lego was actually on the floor with my 7-year-old son, where we spent an afternoon putting together this Lego Ninjago ice tank that I believe belongs to Zane. And that was a really cool experience. There were so many different parts of this that were a complicated build that taught me more about engineering, mechanics, and things of that nature. If you take a look at it, there's a lot of parts that move, that disassemble, and when the tank tracks move, it actually throws a transmission into gear that kind of cycles this giant whatever it is in the back. And my favorite part is it's got a little cannon that actually shoots. This semi-tractor trailer unit was a really fun one to build. I learned a lot about mechanical engineering, especially in the back. There's a dual axle differential, which allows the four tires to turn independently of each other. I thought that was a pretty clever system. And you can see there's all kinds of knobs on this thing. You can steer the front tires, the doors open and close, the seats in the front will recline. In the back here, we've got two lifting cranes that take this cargo container and can actually lift it up and set it down on the ground. There's also a place for the fifth wheel to attach, and you can raise and lower the trailer using this other little knob on the side. Taking a look under the hood, you can see the engine actually has pistons that move up and down as you drive it. And perhaps the biggest project yet is this 4,000 piece industrial digger that I made. It's super complex, a lot of moving parts, and it looks absolutely insane. So after countless days playing with Lego Technics, building all of these different projects, I would consider myself fairly well acquainted with how these parts work. So when Lego came to me and said, what can we do that's really cool, unique, and out of the box? One of the first things that came to my mind was building a Lego drone. Now, we don't want to just build any kind of drone, no siree. We want to build high-speed racing drones, which means these things not only need to be able to look cool, they need to be extremely stable and withstand vibrational forces of brushless motors spinning over 30,000 rotations per minute. Here's the basic idea. We're gonna start by building four identical legs for the drone, then sandwich them between two Lego plates. We're gonna add motors, propellers, an FPV camera, and then drop in this thing we call the brain that connects everything up and makes it all work. Now, if these drone prototypes actually work, Lego Corporation is gonna fly us over to Rhode Island to get together with the hosts of the Ribriculous channel, Tyler and Dimitri, and pit them together one-on-one in an actual high-speed drone race on an indoor arena. And through the magic of editing, that video has already happened. There's a link down in the description right now. You can go and see the results of whether or not those drones actually worked. Go check it out. Now we've got two main parts of this build. One is the actual build, which is 100% Lego Technics, and the second are all the drone components that we're gonna bring in and lay on top of it. We're gonna be doing that in collaboration with a real drone racing pilot I'll introduce you to in a minute. But first, let me show you how to get started on the legs. We're gonna be making four different legs for this platform. All of them are absolutely identical. I'm not gonna list all the names of the parts here because there's too many of them, but if you go to our website, we do have a PDF that you can download that will take you step by step through the rest of this build. In the meantime, just take a really good look at the pieces we got here and let's click them together. Now you notice we got four different arms here that are absolutely identical. Now you can have fun with these. You can change the color of the main support beams. You can change the color of the inside beams. We went ahead and did orange and gray and white here because to us this is gonna end up looking kind of like an X-wing. On the end here, which is gonna be the center part, you can see we put these blue posts and we need those because that's gonna help us connect them to the frame next. Now the frames we're using are 5x7 open frames. We're gonna be using two of them, and I prepped this one already by taking four little posts and using the single side, pushing down into the base there. There's a little ridge so you can't push it any further. And with four of those poking up, we're ready to add the arms. Because these are completely symmetrical on either side, it doesn't matter which way you click them in. You can literally click them in upside down, right side up. It doesn't matter because really it's the same on both sides. With the two parts of our plate assembled, you can see this resembles an X. Now because of these posts in the middle, you can see these can open freely to the center, but they won't go any further outward because the post gets in the way, and that's exactly what we want. The next thing to do is to be able to reinforce these so there's not much wobble and no play to them at all. So for that, we're gonna be building a sandwich to compress the legs together, then use two M15 support beams to build a friction fit and lock the beams in place. These two pieces are the parts we wanna build next. We'll show you what they're made of in just a second, but I just wanted to focus attention on this one. You can see we actually built a little camera mount into this where our FPV camera is gonna sit. The FPV stands for first person view, and those are like the eyes of the drone pilot as they're racing down the track. That's gonna be sitting right here on these brackets. For the top and bottom sandwich plates, we're gonna actually build it in three different pieces. We're gonna build the top plate first, then we're gonna build the camera mount, and then we're gonna build the bottom plate. And these are the different pieces we're gonna be using. This is how they go together. All right, with a few snaps, a few clicks, we've got our top piece finished. You can see we've got corner brackets holding everything together, and the reason we went with corner brackets is because that's gonna be our friction point for pushing the arms together and creating tension. Let's do the camera mount next. So right there we have our support beam and our camera mount complete. All we have left to do is finish our lower support brace. There's our lower support frame, and you can see it's got two pegs sticking up, which will marry perfectly into the base of our camera mount here. When those click together, we now have assembled the unit. Our camera assembly and our lower frame will be one piece. Now we're just gonna put this together like a sandwich. We start with the top piece, we take the X and place it in the center, making sure that our corner brackets are facing down toward it. Then we take our bottom piece with the corner brackets facing upward toward it, and we're gonna fit those in place. And this is the part where now we determine which is front and which is back, because the camera mount is facing forward. Now if you look closer, you can see this M15 beam doesn't quite line up with the holes, and that's exactly what we want. We have to stretch the X apart to get these to lock into place, which creates a friction fit and reduces the vibration. That's a good thing. We want to do the same thing on the back, so we're going to take another M15 beam with two black pegs and pop those into position as well. And just like that, we've got the basic frame for our Stretch X racing drone complete. Now there are a couple things we need to do before moving on. First of all, this is just sandwiched together. It's literally going to fall apart. So we are going to have to bend the rules a little bit and use some fasteners to clamp everything together. Now the holes in the Technic beams are actually the perfect size for accommodating number 10 machine bolts. So I went down to the local hardware store, I picked up 1 1/4 inch machine bolts that pop all the way through, and the hex nuts are just big enough that you can screw them down from the bottom and they will line up almost flush, which is gonna be a really good thing for us. I got 3/4 inch M4 that pop through these holes almost seamlessly on the support beams, and that just makes sure nothing is gonna come apart. It's completely optional, it will work without it, but if you wanna just be extra sure and actually race these things, we would recommend it. All the essentials are now in place, so it's time to add the drone components. And for that, I'm bringing in my friend Spencer, aka Drone Pilot Sputter.
So I'm Spencer. I've been flying drones for about 2 years. I fly under the handle of Sputter. And drone racing is one of the fastest growing sports with over 30,000 people flying every year. I've been to some of the largest drone racing events and flown with some of the top pilots in the world.
Now, I got together with Spencer because up to this point, I really had no experience with disassembling drones and putting them together. At first, I was looking at using some other company's parts and putting them together. But then, Spencer, you came over with some of your equipment, your actual pro drone racing drones, which made it a lot easier to figure out how we're gonna make it work with this Lego base. Let's take a look at some of your components and tell us about what they are and how they work.
On a drone, there's a couple of main components. They all work together. They're interchangeable, kind of like computer parts would be. You start here with the camera. This is what the pilot actually sees. It sends an analog video signal up to these goggles so that I can see. It's kind of like real world virtual reality.
Yeah, very much like playing a video game.
Down inside the drone, there's a couple other parts that help me communicate with the drone with my transmitter, and also gives me this video feed.
There are 6 main components that are absolutely essential to making a racing drone work. First of all, we got the flight controller.
The flight controller is like a little computer that knows what the orientation is of the drone.
The next thing you need are the ESCs.
The ESCs are the parts that actually give power to the motors and tell which motor to spin faster and slower.
The third thing is the motors.
These motors are lightweight, they'll spin up to 30,000 RPM, and have up to a 15-to-1 thrust-to-weight ratio. The camera here in the front transmits to these goggles so I can see what the drone sees. It's like being inside the cockpit.
And this camera transmits in analog, which is actually an older technology, but it's faster to the goggles. If it was transmitting digitally, the latency would be so much of a gap that the drone could actually crash before you see it happen. Along with the camera, the drone has a video transmitter, which is basically just to send the signals back to these goggles.
The transmitter antenna actually receives the signal from your remote control.
Yeah, so whichever way you turn it, that's the way the drone goes. And you do it with one of these things.
There's a couple different protocols that these use. This is probably the most popular one.
Now, essentially what we've done is we've taken all those components, and in the spirit of Lego, we want to make this as plug and play as possible. So we developed this thing. We call it the Squiddy. We were actually really impressed about this. We used a 5x7 open frame, and we were able to find circuit boards that stack together and fit nicely right down through the center. You see all the wiring flows down through the bottom, and we've designed them with banana connectors so that we can plug into each individual motor and the camera as well. These red and black wires on the back will connect to the LiPo battery that powers this. It doesn't get a lot of time in flight. It really only will last for about 2 to 3 minutes when you're really powering these things out. The batteries themselves are about just under 15 volts, but can pump out up to 100 amps, which is absolutely insane.
Because weight is so important when racing, all the smart electronics that would add safety features are removed from these. These are just raw batteries. You need to be careful when you charge them.
The thing I love about this is you just take the top panel off your drone frame, pop this into place, connect everything up, and it's ready to fly. But right now, let's just take this top plate, replace it with our Squiddy, and move on to adding the motors next. These little cameras are only about 20 to 30 bucks. It's really cool because if you put the screws in beforehand, they actually just snuggle right into these brackets perfectly. You can literally just pop them into place and they stay in place, but the camera itself is still adjustable. So we've just dropped the fasteners into place here. We've got everything pretty well assembled, and we've routed the wires so that it looks pretty clean from the underside. We've got three different cables for each motor running out to each respective area. We have two little wires here that will run to our LEDs that we have just going through the center at the back. That little tail sticking out the back that looks like a turtle tail is actually the transmitter for the video transmitter, the VTX. And then we also took the receiver wires. We're very thin, they look like bug antenna. This puts the wires at a near 90 degree angle, which means we have the best chance of being able to control the drone.
We also took a Velcro strap and drilled it through these two holes so we can take a battery and attach it to the bottom.
That way, if you don't feel like building a landing gear for this thing, you can actually just strap the battery on and you're good to go. Keeps it very lightweight. The little pieces that are in the ends of the arms here are these little H-shaped pin connectors. They have two holes in them, which we found are absolutely perfect for attaching the motors. Now, I've still got them attached in here, so you could just attach the motor, but the reason I like this design so much is you could have multiple motors, and if one of them fails, you can just click this out, click the new one into place, plug the wires back in, and you're good to go within seconds.
Most motors use standard connectors, which just happens to be the exact same dimension as this Lego Technic part.
Just happens to be absolutely perfect.
Exactly 16 millimeters. So this just connects right here onto these motor mounts. And then we put two screws right through. On these motors, I've added these connectors so you can swap them out very quickly.
Now all we have to do is make three more of these, swap them out with our existing connectors, and we're just about finished. So we have all the motors connected and attached. Now I just went ahead and randomly plugged all these different cables in, so we don't actually know if the motors are spinning the right way or not. The direction the motor is spinning is very important to actually getting the drone to fly.
These drones run an open source software called Betaflight. We just plug it in and then we can change motor directions. This is called a smoke stopper. If there's any short circuits in our electronics, this will prevent them from frying.
Now, when you are attaching the propellers, here's the only thing that you need to know. You want these things to cut away from you. So when you line up the two propeller blades, it almost should look like two knife blades cutting away from you. One is gonna rotate counterclockwise, the other one's gonna rotate clockwise. So if you look at them and you line up the blades, you just want them both to be pointing away. And of course, on the back, they cut the opposite direction. They cut away to the back, they cut away to the front. If you got those on correctly, it's time to add the nuts. Oh, by the way, I also put together some of these crossbeams that we can put on top for two reasons. One, it'll help protect some of the circuitry if we do crash. And number two, because we actually used them when we went and filmed with Lego. And if you've already forgot, we have a link down in the description where you can go see that video right now and check it out for yourself. There were some unanticipated events that happened. There may or may not have been a mid-air collision. You're gonna have to go see it for yourself. It was a great event, put a really fun twist on this whole project. So links in the description, go check it out. There you go, guys. Our drone is finished and ready for what we call a hover test. This means we get to hook up the battery, take it outside, and let our expert drone pilot fly it around a little bit just to see if we made all the connections correctly. Shall we proceed outside and see what this thing can do? Very nice.
I'm gonna do a little punch out. 3, 2, 1.
That's awesome. All right, next Olympic sport right here. Drone flipping. Lego drone flipping. Yes, nailed it. That was awesome.
That drone flies fantastic. It flies exactly like a real drone. I can hardly even tell the difference. Racing drones are typically made out of carbon fiber because it's so strong and light. This Lego drone is only a little bit heavier than the carbon fiber racing drones that I normally race with. It flies great.
Now, when Spencer mentioned these propellers went about 30,000 RPM, he said, don't get your fingers near it because it kind of actually sliced down to the bone. So just for fun, I went and picked up some hot dogs to kind of simulate what would actually happen. We tied this thing to a 2x4 so we can get this thing spinning as full throttle, and then I'm just gonna dip a hot dog down into it and see what it does. Whoa! What the heck? What? No way. Okay, so our support beam, the 2x4, actually lifted up. That thing's got a lot of thrust. So now we got two more support beams that I'm standing on, and the idea is we're just gonna come in at a safe distance and bring the hot dog in here. Fire it up. One, two, three. Whoa, look at that. Look at that. That is clean.
That was a lot less gruesome, a lot more crisp than I expected.
It was, which means those are sharp. Well, I feel like we've learned something new. These things are not kids' toys.
Here's a fun fact for you.
These Lego drones that we've made can achieve speeds anywhere between 60 to 100 miles per hour.
All right, we're out here at the track. You can see we have some professional pilots racing behind us. We're gonna put our Lego drone up in the air and let it compete and see how it does. We've made some modifications to this. You can see it has a base, so it looks nice and mean. For actual racing, we may wanna take this off, but we'll see how it goes. We've put a 3D printed GoPro mount on top of this drone so you can see what it's like first person view. All right, we got the radar gun. We're gonna see how fast these things go. 86, woo! 81, 83 miles an hour. That is fast.
Hey guys, the fun doesn't end here. Go check out the video we made with Rubriculus. We've got it right up here for you on the top left. If you want to check out some more King of Random videos, we've got those for you on the bottom left. And if you want to subscribe and join the club, go ahead and click the bomb. I'll see you in the next video.